गुड मॉर्निंग नंदुरबार तालुका विधायक समितिस कॉलेज ऑफ एजुकेशन नंदुरबार. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द सिलेबस ऑफ CPS 1/2 करिकुलम एंड पेडागॉजिक स्टडीज इंग्लिश. सो लेट अस स्टडी द सिलेबस वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन दिस पेपर CPS 1/2 करिकुलम एंड पेडागॉजिक स्टडीज इंग्लिश. बिफोर going to see the syllabus, we will learn the objectives of this syllabus. The objectives of this syllabus are to enable the teacher trainee to understand the role and importance of English language in India and in education. Through this paper, we will learn the role and importance of English language in India and in education. Then the second objective of this paper is that understand the concept, nature and importance of content cum methodology in English. We will learn the CCM and we will understand the concept, nature and its importance in this paper. Then third objective of this paper is that understand the approaches, methods and objectives of teaching and learning of English as a second and third language of secondary and higher secondary. Then we have to study the approaches, methods, objectives of teaching and learning as well as the secondary and higher secondary as a second language we will see. Then acquaint her him with planning and testing in the teaching of English. Then we have to see the how to plan and how to test the language. Then we will acquaint her or him with the methodology and techniques of communicative language teaching. The teacher trainee is going to learn the methodologies and techniques of communicative language teaching, then acquaint her or him with the essential aspects of English grammar and usage, as well as the teacher trainee is going to study the essential aspects of English grammar and usage through this paper. Then to enable the teacher trainee to acquire proficiency in the communicative use of language. Then we will be acquiring the proficiency in the communicative use of English language. Then acquiring her him with varied learning resources. There are so many learning resources. We are going to study some of them. Then acquiring her or him with the teaching profession. We will be acquiring through with the teaching profession as a English teacher. We will see it. Then make aware regarding the grammar items. We will see the grammar items throughout this paper. These are the objectives of this paper. So let us see the units and the content of this paper. There are 8 units. The first unit is that unit 1, nature of language. We will see the nature of language or some topics of language. The first one is that the definition, we have to study the some definitions of language, then characteristics of language, then principles of language learning, then place of English. In a place of English, we have to study the place of English according to 3 types. The first one is that in India with special reference to 3 language formula, then in Maharashtra state, and then in present school curriculum. According these 3 points, we have to study the place of English. Then need and importance of English language, we have to study in this unit. Then holidays, 7 basic functions of language, we have to study the 7 basic functions given by EMAC holidays. Then general objectives of teaching English and the instructional objectives of teaching English. These are the subtopics we are going to cover in unit first. That is nature of language. This is the first unit. Then second unit is that content cum methodology. This unit is related to the content cum methodology, that is the concept of CCM. The subtopics of this unit are historical perspective of content cum methodology. We have to study the historical perspective of CCM. Then meaning, concept, nature, structure of content cum methodology, we have to cover. Then scope of content cum methodology, we have to study. Then content analysis, we have to analyze the content according to the CCM methods. Then we have to study the objectives of CCM, that is content cum methodology. Then need and importance of content cum methodology. Then plan and procedures and implementation of content cum methodology. These are the subtopics we are going to cover in unit number 2. Then we have unit number 3, that is developing skills in CLT, that is communicative language teaching. Through this unit we have to study the skills, that is listening skill. Among the listening skill, we have to study the nature of listening skill, types of focus, casual listening, procedures and techniques to develop listening skills. These topics we have to cover in listening skill. Then we have a speaking skill. We have to study the nature of speaking skill, process of teaching speaking skill, then procedures and techniques to develop speaking skills we have to cover. Then we have a reading skill. In reading skill, we have to study the nature of reading skill, types of reading skill, loud reading, silent reading, intensive reading and extensive reading, styles of reading, that is skimming, scanning, then procedures and techniques to develop reading skill. We have to study all these things about the reading skill. Then we have a writing skill, that is we have to study the nature of writing skill, types of writing, copying, dictation, conversation, guided, free composition, procedures and techniques to develop a writing skill we have to study. Then we have a communicative skill, that is we can say talking skill. In this topic we have to study nature of skill integration in communicative skills, procedures and techniques to develop a communicative skills. All these topics and skills we will be covered in unit number 3. Then we have unit number 4. It is related to approaches, methods and techniques of teaching and learning of English. Here in this topic we will learn meaning and concept of approach, method and technique. This topic we will be covered. Then difference between approach and method we have to discuss. Then various methods evolved for teaching English, such as grammar translation method, direct method, bilingual method, Dr. Wes New method, eclectic method, with reference to its nature, principles, application, merits and demerits. All these methods we have to study. Basically, we have to study all these methods in relation to or with reference to nature, principle, application, merits and demerits. Then we have to study various approaches evolved for teaching, such as structural approach is there, communicative approach is there, constructive approach is there, and total physical response approach is there. All these approaches we have to study with reference to its nature, principles, applications, merits and demerits. All these approaches we have to cover its nature, their principle, their application and their merits and demerits. Then we have to study the techniques, devices such as note making, note taking, pair work, group work, storytelling, narration, dramatization and brainstorming. All these techniques we have to study. Then we have to study support services such as language laboratory, audio visual aids, computer and web services. All these topics we are going to cover in this unit, that is approaches, methods and techniques of teaching and learning of English. Then we have unit number 5, that is planning and evaluation. In this unit we have to study types of planning, that is planning, annual plan, unit plan and lesson plan with meaning, framework and merits. We have to study all this plan according to their meaning, their framework and their merits. Then we have to study construction of unit test, that is blueprint is there. Then types of exams, oral, written and practical, all these types we have to study. Then we have to study continuous comprehensive evaluation system, that is CCE. Its concept we have to study, its nature we have to study, types and implementation is there we have to study. This is the unit we have to cover in unit number 5. Then we have unit number 6, that is related to grammar and usage. Here we have to study the phonetics, the sounds of English, vowels, diphthongs and consonants. Then we have to study the word stress, then intonation. Then we have to study kinds of sentences such as declarative sentence, imperative sentence, interrogative sentence and exclamatory sentence. Then we have to study types of sentences such as simple sentence, complex sentence and compound sentence. Then we have to study parts of speech such as noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, prepositions, conjunctions and interjections. All these parts of speech we have to study. Then application of punctuations we have to study. Then auxiliaries and models, all these topics related to grammar and their usage we have to study in unit number 6. Then we have unit number 7, that is teaching as a profession. In this unit we have to study the concept and nature of teaching profession. Then difference between occupation and profession we have to study. Then essential competencies of English teacher. Then characteristics of good English teacher. Then concept of in-service, pre-service teacher training programs. Then training institutions for professional development of the English teacher with special reference to its nature, structure, objectives and function. That is all these such trainings are DCE, SIM and TIFLU. All these teaching training institutions we have to study. Then we have to study English Teacher Association, its nature, its role in professional development. All such topics we have to cover in unit number 7, that is teaching as a profession. Then we have to study the unit number 8, that is learning resources. In this unit we have to study the print resources such as resources for communicating verbal experiences such as textbooks, workbook, magazines, newspaper, encyclopedia and instructional materials. Then the second point is that audio visual aids. These are the three types of aid. First is audio resources, meaning its purpose, educational radio broadcast, tape recorder, language laboratory. All these audio resources we have to study. Then non-projected, that is visual resources, its meaning, purpose, graph, map, poster, charts, pictures, cartoons, diagrams, globes, puppets and models. Then projected, that is visual resources, television, computer with LCD projector, film strips, movies, videos and animations. We have to study in points 2. Then innovative resources such as library as a learning resources, e-resources are there such as blogs, e-book, social networking sites, computer assisted language learning, that is CALL, language laboratory is there for ELT, that is English language teaching, and ELL. All these topics we have to cover in unit number 8. Then advantages and disadvantages of audio visual aids we have to study. This is the unit number 8 we have to cover in our syllabus. Now then we have to complete our practical work is there. Prepare year plan, unit test and blueprint on any unit on CPS 2 from standard 1st to 7. Then this practical we have to complete in this year. These are the some references given in our syllabus. You can take the books from library and study the detail. You can take the references of this book. Okay, thank you. We will start our syllabus from the next video. Thank you.